There are several ways to input notation for unpitched percussion instruments in MuseScore Studio. From version 4.5 onwards, you'll be able to use the new percussion panel, which will appear at the bottom of the app window whenever you click on a stave containing an unpitched percussion instrument. The panel shows drum pads with labels for each instrument or variant in your chosen kit. You can swap between seeing pad names and notation previews by clicking the layout button in the percussion panel header. To start inputting percussion notation, simply click on a drum pad. By default, your notes will take whatever duration you choose up here in the note input toolbar. For example, I can select the eighth note button, then click repeatedly on this closed hi-hat drum pad to enter a string of eighth notes. I can then do the same thing with the ride cymbal. If I now click the bass drum pad, notice how it gets inputted in voice 2 at the cursor position. If you want to input this bass drum on a different beat, just use your left or right arrow keys to move the cursor to the desired beat position before clicking on the drum pad. It's worth mentioning that in MuseScore Studio, drum kit instruments played with the feet are always in voice 2 with the stems down. Now, for keyboard only users, you can navigate to the new percussion panel with the tab key. Once you're there, press the tab key 3 times to focus on a drum pad. Use the arrow keys to move between pads and press spacebar or enter to input notation. At the bottom of each drum pad, you'll see a panel that includes labels for the assigned keyboard shortcut and MIDI note. This makes it really easy to use either your computer or MIDI keyboard to input notation. By default, the first row of the percussion panel is assigned from left to right, keyboard shortcuts A through H. So I can just hit A on my computer keyboard to input a bass drum hit. To assign your own shortcuts, just right-click on a pad and choose Define Keyboard Shortcut. Next, type the key you wish to use for that pad. If you have a MIDI keyboard, you can also use it to quickly enter percussion notation. For convenience, each drum pad shows the MIDI note assigned to it, so you don't have to guess or memorize which sounds are assigned to which notes on your MIDI keyboard. So far, we've seen how to input notation using the drum pads in MuseScore Studio's new percussion panel. Just make sure you choose your note duration first before inputting notation. In MuseScore Studio, this method is called input by note name. You may, however, find it more intuitive to do this in reverse, by first choosing the kind of percussion note you need and then selecting a note duration to input it on the stave. This method is called input by duration, and it can be really helpful for percussion notation. To learn more, check out our dedicated tutorial video about this method, which you can find in the Learn tab or via the link in the description below. Now, another way to enter percussion notation is by using the mouse. This method works best when inputting by note name, so we'll first enter that mode by pressing N or by clicking on this button in the note input toolbar. Next, hover your mouse pointer over the stave. As you move your mouse pointer up and down the stave, you'll see a note preview. Pressing Shift at the same time reveals this small pop-up, which tells you what the instrument or variant is at that stave position. In some cases, you'll be able to click on these arrows to cycle through different variants that exist at the same stave line or space. Once you've found what you're looking for, left-click on the note head to input that note. It's worth pointing out that for each note in every unpitched percussion instrument, the default voice, as well as its stem direction, stave position, and note head style, comes pre-configured based on the sound library chosen for that instrument in the mixer. The sound library also determines the layout of the drum pads in the percussion panel. This makes it possible to ensure accurate notation and playback for whatever instrument you're using in your score. Just be aware that if you change the sound library for a given instrument, any existing notation will likely change too. It's therefore a good idea to decide on the sound library you want to use at the start of your project. If you haven't already done so, it's worth visiting Muse Hub to explore our ever-increasing range of Muse Sounds percussion libraries, all tailored for seamless notation in MuseScore Studio. To learn how to customize both the notation as well as the percussion panel layout itself, be sure to check out our other percussion tutorial videos as they get added to the Learn tab. And if you liked this video, please subscribe to our channel.